It's Toilet Tunes. Now we pause.
It's Toilet Tunes. I'm your host, Sarah Morris. Folks come to my big green bathroom somewhere north of Minneapolis, Minnesota. And we sing a little, we talk a bit, we put it out on the internet just in time for your Friday afternoon. Of course, it's the internet, so you go on and watch it when you choose. But there's a new episode coming out real soon.
My name is Sarah Morris, and I invite people into my big green bathroom, people like Emmy Woods.
Hello.
Hi, Emmy. We're going to sing a song. Not often sung very sadly, but it's real sad, and we're going to do our part to make it sadder.
Go, baby, it ain't fair, you know, to just keep me hanging around. Say you don't wanna hurt me, don't wanna see my tears. Why are you still standing here just watching me drown? And it's alright, yeah, I'll be fine, don't worry about this heart of mine. Just take your love and hit the road. Say you're gonna break my heart anyway, so just leave the pieces when you go. You can drag out the heartache, or baby, you can make it quick, really get it over with and just let me move on. Don't concern yourself with this mess you've left for me. I can clean it up, you see, just as long as you're gone. And it's alright, I'll be fine, don't worry about this heart of mine. Just take your love and hit the road. Nothing you could do or say, you're gonna break my heart anyway, so just leave the pieces when you go.
You not making up your mind is killing me and wasting time. I need so much more than that.
Take on a more conversational stance. We had to get close and intimate with the microphone, but now the mic doesn't need that intimacy anymore. Leave the Pieces is a song that has a big story for me. Tell me, for you, like, what drew you to that song?
Gosh, it just makes me feel really nostalgic. I don't know. It's like when I sing it or when I listen to it, it's like I'm in a pickup truck with old friends driving through a sunflower field, you know?
In South Dakota.
North Dakota.
North Dakota. Yes.
Close.
In a Dakota. I mean, that's amazing. Did you have friends with pickups?
I did. Okay. Yeah. Yeah. I grew up in a really small town, so pickups were quite common.
Yes.
Yes. I drive a Honda Fit now, which I think...
It's the opposite.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's the opposite. I've seen a Honda Fit. My drummer used to drive one with his drums. Yeah, but it's...
I feel like they'd be good for that. They're surprisingly spacious in the back. They're good for hauling gear for sure.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's awesome. It was the Wreckers saying that song, Leave the Pieces, and it's got, like, this really, like, awesome driving. Like, yeah, yeah, yeah. But we thought for the bathroom it might be nice to just be like, yeah.
Mellow out a little.
It was Michelle Branch and Jessica somebody were the Wreckers. They released one album, and it was great. And it was 2000, probably 4 or 5.
I think about then, yeah.
I lived in Nashville. Yeah.
You were in Nashville?
I lived in Nashville at the time. Wow. And my friend was... I knew one of the writers of that song. So I just... This was, like, so iconic and for, like, my nostalgia, too. And my husband and I always used to sing, Leave the Pizza When You Go. Can't just be us that did that. I'm sure a lot of people did. But thank you for bringing it into the Big Green Bathroom. It's just such a goodie.
Yeah, it's such a great song. I really love it. And that's very cool that you knew the person who wrote it.
Yes, Billy Austin and Jennifer Hansen were the two songwriters. And it was fun to watch it. I feel like I knew him as the song was, like, moving up the charts. And, you know, like, to watch that piece of it, which you got to see in Nashville. Because everyone, you know, the grocery clerk, they're writing a hit song. Like, so you see that. And
yeah.
Maybe it's a little different now. I don't know. It was decades ago. But yeah. So thank you.
That's
all right.
Very cool.
Welcome to Toilet Tunes.
Thank you.
Can I talk to you quickly? You've got a beverage. Would you show us what kind of beverage? It's a family of beverages.
It's a cup of coffee.
It's a cup of coffee. I love coffee. How do you feel about coffee?
I'm obsessed with coffee.
Obsessed! Yes! What, like, obsessed in that you must have a lot of it? Obsessed in that you, like, geek out about the peculiarities of coffee? What does obsession to coffee mean to you?
Definitely the first one. I have to have it in the morning.
I need coffee.
Yep. Mm-hmm. Yep. And I usually have to have at least a cup or two throughout the day.
I like it.
I think it's definitely a caffeine addiction.
I believe very much in coffee, and I believe in, as I've gotten older, I've gotten more interested in people who choose to roast coffee. Mm-hmm. And I feel like people who choose to roast coffee or choose to do other, like, small food-based things are much like musicians in that we are just saying, hey, we got this dream, and we're going to go out there in the world and try to make it happen. And what's nice about the coffee people is they help us make our dreams possible, which leads me to our sponsor, WinOMN. Yay! WinOMN is a coffee roasting subscription service. Once a month, they will bring coffee to your door, a bag of freshly roasted coffee from a different local producer. This is up north. They were the January roaster, and... I know it's the beginning of February. That means we're getting our new bag in just a few days. If you were to go to winomn.com, I've got a link below, and use the code STAYTOILETTUNED, you get $5 off. Thank you, Winnow. I know. For supporting dreamers of all kinds, musicians and coffee roasters. They're like the person who brings us all together. Yay! All right. When you're on Toilet Tunes, I have questions to ask you.
Wonderful.
The first question that I'm going to ask is, Emmy, will you tell me something good? Tell me something good in your world, the world. We always need to know more good things.
Yeah. There's a lot of good things, I think. Something I've been feeling really grateful for lately is just, I think that we live in really tough times right now.
Yeah.
Like, I think it's tough times,
but... I think it's generally accepted as a...
Yeah.
Maybe a truth.
Yeah. But I find that sometimes the darkest, hardest times are also like this really beautiful space for human connection. Mm-hmm. And I feel like I've been observing that and experiencing it in really beautiful ways. And just like noticing people sort of, even in this difficult time, kind of becoming their best selves and just really connecting with each other in meaningful, positive ways. I definitely see that in the music community.
Right? Oh my gosh.
Minneapolis.
You can't like take two steps without seeing it. I think we're super fortunate in that way. And my heart hopes that other music communities, I mean, we can only speak to this one. Maybe you, we'll save that for the next question, but I mean, I'd like to think that's how all music communities operate, but the truth of the matter is that I mostly know this community and I just feel very fortunate. And I love what you said there, because I think part of what I heard you say was that you choose to attend to it. You choose to notice these things. And probably the more you choose to look for them, the more you see it.
I think that's true. Yeah. I think that's why gratitude practices in general are good, because they kind of help you see. I had a gratitude journal for a while, which I'd like to start back up this year.
Yeah.
But it changed the way I saw the world, like, because I would be like looking for what to put in my gratitude journal, you know?
Yeah.
And so just these little things throughout my day would be like, ooh, I'm going to write that one down. That's a good one, you know? And so, yeah, I agree. I think it helps you see the good when you're looking for it.
I think it's true. I do tell me something good on a written form every week on Facebook, and the fact that I know I'm going to go out there and share 5 good things that I saw means I have to find them. So even on a week where I'm like super grumpy as all get out, like I still come up. And then what always happens is I have way more than I thought, you know, like I have more than 5. I have 10, you know, like
that's beautiful.
It's a good thing like that. Emmy, you are from North Dakota. How long have you been in the cities?
Oh gosh, about 10 years now. Okay. So it's been a minute. I definitely feel like this is home now.
Yeah. Did you spend any time being in a music community in North Dakota?
Yeah, growing up. So I lived there my first 18 years. Mm-hmm. I moved away for college. But in high school, there's actually a surprisingly cool music scene in Minot. Even then, it's boomed since oil boomed.
So
the population's like tripled. But even back then, there was like a pretty cool punk scene. So in high school, I spent a lot of time going to punk shows.
I've never been to a punk show. Do you think I could still, could I still have an era of punk?
Absolutely.
Could it happen still?
Absolutely. I think.
Could I have it in Minot? Why not?
You could. It's a great place for it. There's some really cool punk bands.
That's awesome. That's super cool. Is there a name that we... Do you have a name of, like, someone we could listen to support?
Oh, gosh.
That's fine. It's fine that you don't. I was like, I didn't know we were going there.
And then
I just thought I'd ask.
I don't, like... It's hard because you don't want to, like... I always have a hard time when someone's like, tell me who I should listen to. Because you don't want to pick just one and then there's others and then,
I get that. Okay, well, after the show, if you do come up with like, this is a really excellent representation of the Minot punk scene, I'll link below. But there might not be a link. There might be a link by the time you see this. There might not. I don't know. We're not making promises. Okay. Anyway.
Yes.
Where are you learning right now?
I feel like I'm in an era of like, everything is learning. Do you ever have
my favorite. Let's be grateful and everything is learning, and Emmy is correct. Yes.
And part of that's like more. I had some like very big changes the last couple years in my life, and it just kind of felt like starting over in a sense. Mm-hmm. Just kind of my whole life just kind of broke down and I'm kind of like rebuilding it and with like a new fresh perspective. And so, yeah, I feel like everything feels kind of new right now. I've only been performing regularly for like the last 2 years. So as far as music goes, I'm learning a lot. Just like everything from how to book myself to like collaborating is new. So this was very fun.
Good. It was fun for me.
Yeah. Thank you. Playing with a band is new.
Red Pine Ramblers.
Yeah.
Yes. And you play with them probably more than monthly, but you definitely have a monthly residency with them, right? At the 331? Am I dreaming?
Yeah. No, okay. You're absolutely right.
Tell us that. Second
Sundays of the month, we are at the 331 Club.
From 7 to 9.
7 to 9 p.m. Yeah.
The best hours. Good job.
Yeah, I really love those hours because they're, you know, it's a reasonable hour. Because they're not after 10. Yeah, but it's also after dinner, so, you know.
Yeah. I agree. That's awesome. So beautiful.
Thank you.
Yeah. So where are you learning for me tends to be like an acute, it's a in this moment question, but the next one is like the partner of that, but in a more like what's been part of your whole last era. What for you is the steady beat of it? Something that you can return to time and time again when you need support or inspiration, or it's like what sustains you in a steady way?
Yeah.
Good.
The heartbeat. I think songwriting's kind of the thing I come back to. Because sometimes, especially now that I've been performing, like, that takes a lot of emotional energy, you know? Like, sharing all of these, you know, personal stories or just feelings with people. And sometimes I have to just, like, make sure I'm being intentional about sort of coming back to like the songwriting, because that's really what I was doing before I was performing. I was writing songs. I just wasn't sharing them.
Really?
So how it's always that time of your life.
Like how many? Gosh. What like kind of an era was that? Like how long?
A lot of years. I started writing songs pretty early on, just kind of as soon as I started learning how to play guitar, and I played out a little bit over the years, but there's a period of, I don't know, probably like 10 years where I just kind of decided performing wasn't for me and I wasn't going to do it, but that I still really wanted to write songs and play music. Mm. And so I just kept doing that and I was just kind of doing it for me.
Yeah.
And now that I am performing, I just like have to remind myself sometimes that that space is still there, that like music can still be just for me.
Yeah.
And so I would say that's kind of like the heartbeat of it for me is the songwriting.
I love that. Yeah. I heard this interview. I'm wanting to learn more about poetry and like experience poetry more. And in the interview, the poet Jane Hirschfield was talking about how poetry has like worked its way. It used to feel more like anyone could just write poems, you know, like it. And now it seems like poetry is seen as like you are the poet laureate, or you're a teenager with feelings. You know, like there isn't this accessibility for the middle, like just for, like we could all just be poets. And when you said that thing about songwriting, I think, you know, like I've always sung my songs out, but there's so much room for like just, we can all just be songwriters. We can all just write songs. Like the world, even if no one ever hears your song, I, in my woo-woo way, am convinced like you are a changed person for having written it, probably a healthier, happier human, because you processed your business in a way that's like part of art. Yeah.
Absolutely. Yeah. So
let's all be songwriters and poets. And you don't have to share it with anybody.
Unless you want to.
Unless you want to. And then you should totally share with everybody.
Yeah.
How beautiful. All the freedom. I like that. Can you take us by our ears? Spin our ears out into some new music. Doesn't have to be new music. Music that is like getting you all excited right now. Hot and bothered is what I like to say. That to me means like kind of, ooh, I love listening to this. But like, what's something that's really inspiring you right now musically?
Yeah, I've been listening a lot to Paris Paloma the last couple few months, I would say.
Yes. Did you choose Paris Paloma for the about that
I
song?
Did.
Yes,
I
yes,
did.
Yes. Okay.
I'm kind
Say
of
more.
Obsessed.
Tell more.
Yeah, yes. Yeah. I'm kind of obsessed. She's just very like empowered and empowering. Like her lyrics are very much like, yeah, just sort of embracing a sense of empowerment while also the song I picked for that. Mm-hmm. I'm trying to think of which one it's called. As Good a Reason. Mm-hmm. Like, I feel like it's very much about empowering other women too.
Yeah.
And so I love that. And so I've been getting a lot of strength from that. I have also been listening to a lot of Lily Carlisle is a favorite of mine.
Okay.
Right now too. Kind of, I mean, he sings about like modern things and his life and perspective, but it's very much like old-timey sounding.
Cool.
So that's kind of fun to sit with that too.
I will link to both of those things below. I'm also going to link to, so Emmy, I got to interview you for about that song, this little blog I do, and I was really moved by your songwriting answers. You told a story about a song about a dear friend that you wrote. You have a new single that it's new, A Million Miles.
Yeah, it just came out. Right? Okay. Yeah, A Million Miles Per Hour came out in December.
That song is perfect for winter.
It's a very wintry song.
I mean, not the winter we're having, but it's if we were a snowy winter.
It's true, there hasn't been like a lot of good sledding.
No.
The chorus is about sledding, and there just hasn't been a lot of good sledding weather.
When I lived in Nashville, it snowed the first winter like this, you know, like nothing, like half an inch, and everyone was sledding. It was like immediately, like grab your giant cardboard box and go down whatever thing is kind of a hill. And I was like, what is happening here? This isn't real snow. But it's all relative.
Yeah, yeah. I lived in Washington State for a few years, and I remember my first winter there, it, like, barely snowed, and, like, everything shut down.
That's right.
And I was kind of, like, having grown up in this area, I was like, what's happening? It's kind of funny. Yeah.
It's good to know things, to learn things, to experience different ways. So I've linked to places that they can find your music. Mm-hmm. And you're talking about where you're learning. If you've only been, like, playing out, did you say just 2 years, really?
As far as, like, performing regularly.
Okay. Yeah. Well, what I think is amazing is that part of what you're doing is that you have these three residencies, right? You have three monthly gigs?
Yeah. One of them is something I just set up. I don't perform at it, but yeah.
But no, but that, I guess to my point, is, like, you're choosing to spend some of that time bringing other people together, which I think is beautiful, dialing us back to, like, we got this great community. So can you tell us quick about your three events that are steadies? Because they're a steady beat, too.
So there's the 331 residency, which we talked about before. That's second Sundays from 7 to 9 p.m.
Yep.
And it's a new thing for them to have music on Sundays, but they do now every Sunday night from 7 to 9, they have music. So that's great. And then I also work with Insight Brewing to do Sunday sessions. And that's every third Sunday of the month from 4 to 7. I always play a set, and then there's two other songwriters that play a set. And then the third one is, like I said, I'll perform at it every once in a while, but mostly I just like booking it, and just kind of, it kind of gives me a reason to like bring other songwriters I like together and just enjoy their music.
Yeah. Oh my gosh. Yeah. Heck yeah.
Yeah. And that is at Metronome Brewery in their listening room called Fingal's Cave. And it's really cozy. It's kind of like, it has sort of like living room show vibes, but also kind of like speakeasy, cute little bar vibes.
Fun.
And it's, the acoustics are really great in there.
That's the third Wednesday?
That's the third Wednesday of the month, yeah. And,
So I've listed your website below so people can learn all about that. And you have a new album coming out or new singles? What's coming up?
I have a few singles that I'm sitting on. I have a few songs with the band that have been recorded, but I'm waiting to have them mixed. So that's the next big thing. But this year there will definitely be more music coming out. And then I do have an album in the works. Like, the songs are written, and I need to come up with some arrangements and work with some other musicians. But that, I'm hoping to at least finish it by the end of the year. Whether or not it'll be released, I don't know.
Well, you'll learn things by following Emmy in all the places that I have said. Let's put our hats on for this last bit, because we were going to wear hats, and then we didn't wear hats, but it is hat weather, so let's do that. And I'm going to thank the sponsors one more time. So I'm going to thank Winnow again. Winnow MN. Stay Toilet Tuned is your coupon for $5 off your first bag. And then your days are going to be happier, because you will have connected with like a dreamer, a coffee dreamer. And that coffee will fuel your dreams. I believe it. And then my forever beloved sponsors, the Sarah subscribers over at Toilet Tunes. These hearts are people who at some point or another have said, yes, I want to be part of this community that says Sarah's crazy, but we're going to support her music making. And I just love all these people so much. So thank you. And if you want to learn more about that, I've linked to that below. That's over on Patreon. And Toilet Tunes airs Fridays at noon. Emmy Woods, thank you so much for joining me.
Thank you for having me.
I appreciate it.
This
and
is a delight.
Until next Friday, I want you to stay toilet tuned.
It's alright, I'll be fine. Don't worry about this heart of mine. Just take your love and hit the road. Nothing you could do or say, you're gonna break my heart anyway. So just leave the pieces when you go.